Hello, welcome to the SAP ABAP training program. Here we are going to learn about the ABAP data dictionary this picture has made. Data suppose are stored usually in the database. Perfect. So all these data are like, you know, millions of data are there in a database. As a customer or an employee, I don't want these millions of data. I need a set of data which is required for me. So I need to define some way that what is the structure of data, what is the table type, what is the structure defined, what is the requirement that I will define in the ABAP data dictionary, and I will store it there, and so that that set of data is required, it will be required for me, and that is called the underlying database. The database, from the database we will take the data and keep it in the underlying database. Now remember, when you create a database, you must create an underlying database or create a table. You will create a table actually, or a structure or a data type you will create. You must create and keep it this thing in object. The object, this thing in a package. So the package, what is you must have defined. So the package can be defined with the starting letter of Z. Then you can give your own name. I have just given BK08 so that my package will be unique and different from others. Then underscore, you can give a name of the package. So if you create a package and you can keep a main package, you can create a main package also, or you can create a development package under the main packages. So usually the package that you are creating is called the development package, and the multiple development package, suppose three persons are using. So one, two, three are using three different development package, and your project head is using the main package, and so all main package person can compile can link from 1, 2 and 3, and he can create and he can manage the entire project. So that is how the package creation is a must before you go for a development of any table on any object. So let us see what is the data, ABAP data dictionary. ABAP data dictionary is like, it's create and store data definitions or metadata. So as I told you, all the data are stored in the database. So it is just like taking a data from the database or required set of data, and it must be defined and stored in the underlying database. So what is the purpose of doing all those things is that it is a central repository. Like you have a central database system in the college, so all the data are stored in the central database, and now it is being used with all the departments. So it is a good sign. So if somewhere a student will come and say that I need to change my address, so one place it will change and it will reflect in all the departments. So what is that is the advantage of central repository. Next is your avoid redundancy. Let's say a student is there with a student branch mark 1, student branch mark 2. If I go on writing for a student branch mark 10, so I am writing the name of name 10 times. Rather than that, I should write student name branch mark 1, mark 2, mark 3, mark 4, one name. And all the documents, like 50 all things must be there in a single row. That is called, the name will not repeated multiple times just for different purpose. So it's avoid the redundancy of data. Another thing is the security, data security is there. Data security is a very important term, like all the data should not be shared with everybody. So the data are there, so you need to select a particular column will not be shared with anyone. So you can have that format that certain set of data cannot be shared with others. Only the required data will be shared with the other departments. And then to ensure the data integrity and data consistencies. So you can add the data whenever you want, and you can have an integrity that data will be secure and there will be not like misplace of data, or there is an error in the data, this will not be happen. So all this is possible if you create, then you can create a different tables, data type, search help, domain, all the things you can create as objects, and these objects you can keep in the package, and all these things what you create the object, all these things will be stored in the ABAP data dictionary. So here we are going to just know that what is how to create a table in a ABAP data dictionary. So this is the screenshots of every step that we are going to do. So initially you have got SAP Easy Screen, Easy Access. So in the Easy Access, you go there and you go to the ABAP dictionary and SC11. You can write your SC11 also, SC11, and you will get an next screen called ABAP dictionary initial screen. In the ABAP dictionary initial screen, that you can see that data table, view, data type, group, domain, search help, and lock object. You can go for like create a type first or create a domain first or create a data type first, anything you can create first, or you can create a directly a data table first. So let us write a name of the data table and try to have and just go for a create of the data table. Just before that, just know that the ABAP data dictionary is compatible with the ABAP workbench. So what is the compatibility of the workbench, and that all the tools in the ABAP workbench can be compact, can use the data dictionary, and that is the underlying database can be used there. So you can modify or change or append or create anything in the database. And the good thing about it is that you can certain objects. So suppose you are creating a multiple records and one particular multiple columns and multiple structures. So you can have an option of you can keep it active or you can keep it inactive. So runtime system uses only active version. So if I have got a 10 objects I created, one of the object certain set, so three objects I know I'm not interested to use. So I will just keep that three objects inactive and the seven objects I will keep it active. So I can use the seven objects. So that is a good thing about the ABAP data dictionary, that it can active and inactive, and active portion will be used in the application thing. Thus objects can be changed without affecting the dependent applications. So that is the advantage of the ABAP data dictionary. So as I told you, in the SAP system, there is an underlying database. With the database, we take it and same structure as the database table definition in the ABAP data dictionary. So whatever the definition of the table we create, according to that, we create a table and that table can be found. So a transform table in the ABAP data dictionary has one-to-one projection to the underlying database. So whatever the data ABAP data dictionary is being structure has been formed, so we can have one-to-one table or one-to-one data will be like will be formed in the underlying database table. When transparent table is defined in ABAP data dictionary, exactly one database table with identical names and field is created in the underlying database. So this is we have just discussed that in the underlying database. So whatever the transparent table is found, so exactly that same whatever the structure we define, the same table will be found in the underlying database. So that is the good thing about a transparent table. Similarly, we have got a cluster table, we have pool table, we have global temporary tables. So as you there with the database table, so let us say I created a name ZBK08_P. So sorry. You can have like jet this in name ZBK08. Instead of this name, you can create your own name there, underscore the file name there. So you can create this with the like in the first you must write with the MANDT, then you must have a registration number, then role number, name, branch, age and year. So I have just created one table. MANDT is a must because it refers to the client that you are, that is why it is must be a key. And it is that the client is 800, so we are separated from the client which is having another name. So this is a mandatory, MANDT must be there, and the data element is also MANDT. Other names you can create. Let us see how we can create the different names. So before that, let us have an objective that create a transparent table. But in this objective, you have a file name that is your code, that is you can have your name underscore IGIT underscore address. Let me define the objective is you create this big table with IGIT main, then I want that another sub one and another is address one. So sub one will take the name from the main table and it can give the email ID, personal details are there. And inside the sub one there is an address which will only handle with the address part of this table. And this table handles the name part of this table. So let us have a database where we have a set of this. Inside it we have a name and initial all their personal details, and inside it we have an address and all the personal details. And we are linking that with the field called name and father's name. So I don't think that the name and father's name of all the any will be have a common name and father name, it means different. Let us assume that they are different. So to understand that, let us have a name. These are the variables. Name is a variable, and let us discuss only one. So let us say name is a variable, and the data element will be Z. YN stands for you take your own name, then underscore S name. If this is the name of the entire data element, so this is a variable field name, the component, or this is the data element, and this is the characteristics it should have. Character, because the name is usually the maximum length can be 20 characters. And now for this name also you have the jet YN underscore S name is the student name and F name is the father name. So it's also the character is 20. So when we have both the characters 20, 20, can I form a one group like domain zyn underscore name? This domain defines that it is a character and of 20 letters, but data element defines, this is our data elements, it defines that it is like semantically they are having a different meaning, but technically they are having the same character. Similarly, we can have the data fields, we can have the data elements, we can have the characters, and this is the domains. Because I chose a domain here initially so that the structure is clear in front of you, so that now you can create the table. So let us take a new table, that is the ZBK08. So you just change, when you create just these things, you should not be copying it, rather you will create your own code. Other things you can make a same copy of it. So let us click on the create button. When you create button, observe the constraint for use in a logical database. Some users comment will come, just put a tick mark. Then you have what this table will come. In this table there is a blank space, so you please define here like short description of the table. So short description is IGID student address created by BG. So if it is not required, you can just write a size short description. Then inside it there is a delivery class and data browser table view maintained. Delivery class is that here you have, if you click on the help button over here, so you will get delivery class. So in the delivery class we have got an application table, because this is a master and an application table, so you just type here A. So here you will say A, and then you have a display and maintenance allowed with restriction, so you will leave that, and rather you will go for display and maintenance allowed, and this is being set here. So here in the table, in the delivery class maintenance, you will put application table and display maintenance allowed. Then we'll have next is when you press the save button, when you press the again okay enter button here, then you will go for a package creation. In this package creation they will ask you where you will keep the store the this object. So you need to write down here package. So as I told you, you must have a package there, otherwise you can go for a default package also, but it is better to store everything in a single package. So just type the name your package that is there. So I just type the name here zbk08 underscore igit and put the save button. So it will be saved in the package. So number request number will be generated of the package, and inside the request number you press continue and your data is saved. So just see here one new thing, new revise, you can see that here, and here you will see the new is coming here. So and whatever difference you can see on these two screen is this save button is coming, zbk underscore igit address is saved. So once it is saved, so how it is saved, we press the save button. So once you press the save button, this is saved, then you have the for the activate button, then you must go for activate button. Now see that we go for the activate button here, and once you go for the activate button, then we will see that this is saying that this is saved. Then you go for the activate button, and then after activate it will take you to the another screen called the maintain technical setting. So it is drag me to the another screen, that is the technical setting is to be saved, otherwise it will not activate. So technical setting, it will ask for that which technical setting. So this is my master data and transparent table. So APPL01, this will be APPL0 will be overwritten here. So you will click here and just say enter. So now what is the delivery classes? Delivery classes, it will control the transport of table data during installation, upgrade and client copies. So A means store application data in this table, and data